So we are, how much did we do? Front of the thigh we have started with, right? So I think we have done the femoral triangle boundaries, isn't it? So after that we were talking about the contents. What are those? Femoral artery, vein and femoral nerve, isn't it? Then I told you like the upper few centimeters of the femoral vessels are covered with a protective sheath. As you see in head and neck, we have carotid sheath. In the lower limb, we have femoral sheath. Okay, so it is covering 3 to 4 centimeters of the femoral vessels in the upper part. Anybody remembers the boundaries of femoral triangle? Base, see it is a triangle, right? So how is the base formed? Inguinal ligament. How is the medial border formed?
By the doctor, longest muscle,
Lateral?
lateral bo
Sartorial.
lateral sartorius,
Sartorius. Apex?
meeting point.
Point, yeah. Meeting point of sartorius and the adductor longus. Very good. Okay. Then how is the roof formed? Skin superficial fascia. What is the deep fascia of the thigh called as?
Facial lata.
What are the modifications of fascia lata?
The iliotibial tract and tensor fascia lat I don't know.
Iliotibial tract,
Iliotibial tract.
saphenous opening, cribriform fascia, and
Cribriform
intermuscular
fascia.
septum. Okay. Then now, how is the floor formed? Femoral triangle. IPPA
The iliacus, psoas major, pectineus, and the doctor longus.
Very good. Iliacus, psoas major, pectineus, and adductor longus forms the floor. Contents are vein, artery, and nerve. Okay. So like this, vein and artery are enclosed by the femoral sheath, what we are talking about. Okay, so this is a quick review of what we have already studied. So it is covering the upper 3 to 4 centimeters of the femoral vessels in upper part. Okay, now see here, beta. See, this is the anterior superior iliac spine, and this is pubic tubercle. So in between this, what is this green structure you have? Connecting inguinal ligament, isn't it? Yes, Emma. From anterior superior iliac spine to the pubic tubercle, we have this inguinal ligament. So this inguinal ligament, when we have studied in abdomen, I told you it has certain modifications, like it is getting reflected upwards, isn't it, towards pectin pubis. So these reflections are lacunar ligament. Okay. Now see here, the same. Upper 3 to 4 centimeters of the femoral vessels, they are enclosed in this pink sheath. For our easy understanding, this color has been used. So this is nothing but femoral sheath. So if you remember in my previous class, I told you the contribution of femoral sheath. Anteriorly, how is it formed, and posteriorly, how is it formed? Anteriorly, fascia transversalis, posteriorly, fascia iliaca. Okay. Fascia iliaca is the fascia which is covering iliacus muscle, and fascia transversalis we see just above the peritoneum. Okay, as a part of anterior abdominal wall below the anterior abdominal wall muscles. Is that clear? Okay, then. Now if you, now from this picture you can make out, if this is pubic tubercle, obviously this will be medial and this will be lateral end. Okay, so what are the structures we have beta? In the femoral sheath, medially we have femoral vein, laterally we have femoral artery. Okay, now this femoral sheath, if you just look like this, you are seeing it is divided into three compartments. By means of two transverse septae, we have 1, 2, and 3. How many compartments this femoral sheath has? Three compartments. Medialmost compartment is basically having so much of a connective tissue, and here actually it is called as femoral ring. We will discuss in detail now itself. The middle compartment is containing femoral vein. The lateral compartment is containing the femoral artery. Along with this, in the lateral compartment, we will also see femoral branch of genitofemoral nerve. Okay, femoral branch of genitofemoral nerve. So these are the three subdivisions of femoral sheath. Okay. See, as Imad was telling us, the boundaries of femoral triangle, base is inguinal ligament. Now medially, we have the medial border of adductor longus. Laterally, we have the lateral border of sartorius. Apex is the meeting point of these two muscles. And upper 3 to 4 centimeters of these femoral vessels is enclosed by femoral sheath. Okay. So three compartments of femoral sheath, isn't it? Medial, intermediate, and lateral. Medial compartment. What is the other term written here for the medialmost compartment of the femoral sheath? What is it called as? Yeah, femoral. Okay, femoral ring. It has clinical significance. We will discuss the boundaries, how it is formed anteriorly, how it is formed posteriorly. I will tell you. So, if you just consider the medialmost compartment, what is the composition? What is it containing? Lymph node.
Lymph node.
Lymph node. Okay, better. Hey, ma'am, my voice is clear, no?
Yes, ma'am. Yes. Huh.
Okay. So this is femoral vein and this is femoral artery compartment where you have genital branch of, femoral branch of genital femoral nerve. Now, what is the contribution of, already we discussed it will be a revision. How is it formed? So formation, this femoral sheath anterior contribution comes from fascia transversalis. Okay, this is the anterior contribution. Posterior contribution, it comes from this muscle covering. This muscle is iliacus muscle covering iliacus, whatever sheath is there, that is fascia iliaca. So posterior wall is contributed by fascia iliaca. Anterior wall of femoral sheath is contributed by fascia transversalis. Okay, and this becomes the lateral wall, which is vertical, whereas medial wall is sloping downwards like this. This is lateral wall, which is downwards straight, whereas medial wall is sloping downwards. Okay, and laterally, the direction is like this. Okay, that's what medial wall slopes downwards and laterally. Okay, then now what is the function? Why is this femoral sheath present? So it allows free sliding of femoral vessels, okay, beneath inguinal ligament during movements of hip joint. Okay, that is in the newborn, it is rudimentary due to fetal position of flexion. That means it's not so much well developed in the newborn baby. Then already we know how many compartments it has. See, this is the pubic symphysis, this is anterior superior iliac spine. So this is medial end, this is lateral end. So how many subdivisions femoral sheath has? Three compartments, isn't it? This is the medial most compartment, middle and lateral. Okay, medial, intermediate and lateral words also you can use. This gray in color is actually representing lymphatic vessel. There we have lymph node, right? In the middle compartment, we have femoral vein. In the lateral compartment, we have femoral artery. Okay, so femoral sheath is enclosing femoral vessels. And the femoral nerve is lying outside the femoral vessels. Okay? So divided into, what are the various compartments we have? Lateral, intermediate, and medial compartments. So femoral nerve is present outside the femoral sheath. Okay, beta? Then. So whatever I told you is written, beta. So laterally, we have femoral artery. Not only that, we have femoral branch of genital femoral nerve. In the middle, we have femoral vein and medial most is the femoral canal. Okay. So this femoral canal is actually containing lymph node, black arrow. Okay. This is one of the deep lymphatics of the inguinal region, which is given a special name, which is called as lymph node of Clockett or lymph node of Rosenmüller. Okay. That is. Now this is our femoral canal. So it is like a cone. Okay, this whole thing, medial most compartment of femoral sheath is femoral canal. Uppermost covering is ring, femoral ring. Okay, and this is our femoral canal. So when you just measure it, you see it is 1.25 centimeters long, and base is this black in color is femoral ring. Okay, that is. No. So again, this is see here. What are we finding here? This is the femoral canal, which is shown in pink color. Okay. So the roof of which I told you it has loose connective tissue, that is actually femoral septum. And there you will find one depression, that is the femoral fossa. Okay. So now see here, this boundaries of femoral, this femoral ring, femoral canal itself can be a 3 marks question. Femoral sheath is 5 marks question. Though they are small, small things, but they are very, very important. But, so boundaries of ring, see in the front, it is contributed by inguinal ligament. Behind, the floor of femoral triangle, which muscle, so many muscles behind, no? So behind this femoral, like the posterior boundary of the femoral ring is contributed by pectineus, okay? Medially, the base of the lacunar ligament. I told you lacunar ligament is the reflection of inguinal ligament. Okay, so this is apex of lacunar ligament and this is base if you just consider it as a triangle. Okay, so medially this femoral ring is bounded by the base of lacunar ligament. Laterally, it is bounded by femoral vein. Okay, and overall this ring is completely closed. It is obliterated because of the presence of femoral septum. Okay, I'll take you to other picture. See, this is the whole thing, no? So anteriorly, you are finding this inguinal ligament only. Okay, then posteriorly, pectineus muscle. Medially, the reflection of inguinal ligament, that is the base lacunar ligament. Laterally, you are just finding one septum which separates this femoral ring from the intermediate compartment where we have femoral vein. Okay. So these are the boundaries. Okay, you just read slowly, you will remember everything. Okay, beta? That is. Now, what does it do? Why do we have that empty space there? So it is allowing the expansion of femoral vein during increased venous return of lobotomy. Okay, allows expansion of femoral vein. So whenever venous return is increasing, so then this free space what we have in the level of femoral ring, that will allow the expansion of the femoral vein. Okay. Now, structures piercing the femoral sheath. One thing we have seen along with the artery, so we have seen femoral branch of the genitofemoral nerve. Okay, apart from that, you will see superficial branches of femoral artery. Now, can anybody tell me what are the superficial branches of femoral artery?
Superficial external pudendal, superficial epigastric, and superficial circumflex iliac.
Very good. Excellent. Superficial circumflex iliac, superficial external pudendal, and superficial epigastric. These are the three branches, okay, which you see they are piercing the femoral sheath. Okay, great saphenous opening is also seen piercing the cribriform fascia, and then it will be entering inside the femoral sheath to enter into the femoral vein. Okay, that is. So I hope just Chavi has joined late. So just I'll show you the picture. We were just talking about femoral sheath, Chavi. It has three compartments. Okay, medial, intermediate, and lateral. Medial most compartment is the femoral canal. It is guarded by femoral ring. Okay, in like medial compartment contains lymph node. Intermediate compartment contains femoral vein. Lateral compartment contains femoral artery, okay, which is also pierced by the femoral branch of genitofemoral nerve. That's what we have studied. Anterior wall of femoral sheath is contributed by fascia transversalis. Posterior wall is contributed by fascia ilia. I also told about the boundaries of femoral ring. Okay, then, so we know like basically it is allowing the expansion of the veins during increased venous return. Femoral hernia, so this is a free space, isn't it? The femoral canal, 1.25 centimeters length canal, what we have here is a empty space where we have only one small lymph node. So much of loose areolar tissue is there. So whenever intra-abdominal pressure is increased, there are chances of abdominal visceral organs to herniate, to go and enter into the femoral canal. So this is what is called as femoral hernia. Okay, visceral, like you can see loops of intestines entering into the femoral canal. And unfortunately, it is common in females The reason is, first thing is, the veins and arteries diameter is comparatively smaller in case of female. Okay, because of which the space which is there for femoral canal, that will be big, so that abdominal organs can easily herniate. Second reason is increased abdominal pressure, which can be encountered during delivery of the baby, that is parturition, or any chronic obstructive lung disorder, COPDs, where always cough is there in such cases also, where intra-abdominal pressure is increased, you can see like hernia is possible. Okay, the protrusion of abdominal organs into the femoral canal. Okay, so that is, this is how it looks. This is the inguinal hernia. Okay, in the inguinal canal, if the organs are protruding, you call it as inguinal hernia. In the femoral canal, if you see the abdominal organs are protruding, then it is femoral hernia. Okay, you can see the direction is downwards, forwards, and it is coming near the midline. Okay, so basically, when you see if the abdominal organs are coming down, they also carry the covering of peritoneum. What is the covering of intestine called as mesentery, isn't it? Mesentery for small intestine. Then for colon, we had transverse mesocolon, sigmoid mesocolon, isn't it? Mesoappendix, meso word I asked you to remember as a prefix to just represent the peritoneal covering. So coverings of hernia, we will see the peritoneum, the femoral septum, that is the septum what it was separating from the venous compartment. Anterior wall of the femoral sheath. How is it formed? Fascia transversalis. Cribriform fascia, that is nothing but seen at the saphenous opening and skin. Okay, that means organ is coming out in that direction. Okay, like this. It is felt just below the skin. Okay, that is the meaning. So you can go the other way. Skin, below the skin, cribriform fascia, then anterior wall of femoral sheath, that is the fascia transversalis, femoral septum, then peritoneum. Okay, peritoneum is the covering which the intestinal loop is carrying. Okay, that is. So treatment, what we should do, we should push it back manually. Okay, and then we have to just close the femoral ring tightly, suture it.